Welcome in, everyone, to the Tuesday episode of the David Hookstead Show. I'm happy to have you all here, as you can tell by my voice. Still a little bit under the weather after that trip to Florida for a great wedding. But as always, I'm going to push through because that's what the American spirit is all about. We're never going to bend. We're never going to break. If I'm on my deathbed, I'll still be here giving you guys the best videos on the internet. So let's not waste any time. And the first thing I want to talk about today with all of you is this hammer thrower Olympian, Gwen Berry. I actually meant to talk about this on the Monday show, but just totally forgot to put it on the list of topics. Gwen Berry is a hammer thrower who qualified for the Olympics after finishing third. And when they played the national anthem, not only did she not stand proudly with her hand over her heart, as I think many Americans who have great respect for this nation have, do, she had an activist athlete t-shirt. She looked away from the flag. She essentially sat there and pouted because they were playing the anthem. And then maybe just as bad, she took to social media after the fact and essentially doubled down and said people were obsessed with her and so forth and so forth. And this is the point I want to make about this. And I'm going to be as blunt as possible because it's what you deserve to hear. If you cannot stand and respect the national anthem on an international stage, we're not talking about the NFL, which is just played here in the country. I'm talking about on the international stage. If you cannot stand for the national anthem when you're wearing the red, white, and blue, then you have no business going to the Olympics. If you hate America that much, you have no business wearing this country's colors while competing against other nations. And keep in mind, not just other nations that are like us, you have no business disrespecting this great freedom-loving country when you go out there and compete against the likes of China, North Korea, Iran, the Russians, any litany of other dictatorships around the world where free right or civil rights, civil liberties, free speech, the Second Amendment, those things don't even exist in those countries, right? Those people are subjects of their dictatorships and nothing more. If you want to behave that way on the podium and you hate America that much, then stay home. It's that simple. Stay home. Don't go to the Olympics. Don't represent the United States of America. Everything this country has wrong with it, and there's not a lot wrong with it. We are the greatest country in the world. Now, we make mistakes from time to time. Every country does. We're not perfect. We're run by humans. As any good Christian will tell you, no human is perfect. And when you are run by imperfect humans, you're not going to have a perfect society. However, the moment we leave the United States of America, that shit stays here. That stays within our borders. We don't take that to the international level. We don't embarrass the United States of America in front of other countries. We don't air political grievances at the Olympics. That's not what we do. What the United States of America does is win gold medals, win world wars, send men to the moon, win the miracle on ice, and when we're competing against other countries, we are united as a single front, okay? Any disagreements you have with how the United States of America handles things, they stay here in the United States behind closed doors. Behind closed doors. They don't happen in front of the whole world so that everyone can mock us and laugh at us, so that the Russians and the Chinese who just get rid of people who criticize their government so they can make a fool out of us on the international stage. Gwen Berry is nothing more than a useful idiot. And if she's going to go to the Olympics and behave like this, she's going to be a propaganda piece for every country that hates the United States of America. And furthermore, if you hate the United States of America that much, why do you even want to go to the Olympics? Why? If you hate this country, which has done so many amazing things for people around the world, why even go? If I hated someone or I hated something or I hated a nation or a sports team, I wouldn't wear their colors. I wouldn't participate with them. I wouldn't play for them. Why is it any different with the Olympics? If Gwen Berry feels this way, stay home. This country liberated Europe from the Nazis. We crushed the Japanese Empire, which was doing absolutely horrific things. And I'll be damned if a U.S. athlete now goes to Tokyo, a country that essentially enslaved Asia during World War II, and behaves in a manner that mocks this great nation, okay? We're not perfect, but we're the closest thing to perfect this world has ever seen. And for Gwen Berry to stand on that podium like a petulant child and behave the way she did makes a mockery not just of this great nation, but of every man and woman who ever wore the uniform abroad, going abroad just like the Olympics to bring freedom to people around the world. It's bullshit. And every single person who cares about the The red, white, and blue, the stripes and the stars, the Star Spangled Banner should be just as upset about this as I am. You don't have to agree with everything this country does. You don't have to be Republican or Democrat to understand that when we get on a plane and we travel overseas, we are representing the United States of America. We're representing the history that came before us. We're representing all this country's great accomplishments. That's what you're representing when you put that uniform on in the Olympics to compete overseas. Herb Brooks is rolling in his grave at the idea that we're going to compete on the highest level and we're going to have athletes who spit in the face of this great nation while wearing our own colors. It's despicable. And for everything this country has done to help the less fortunate within our own borders and overseas, for Gwen Berry to behave this way, thinking she's now going to be Colin Kaepernick 2.0. If I was running, and she qualified, so she's going to go. There's really nothing you can do at this point. But if I was running the Olympics for the United States of America, I'd make it very clear. You get out there and protest during the national anthem, or you get out there and sling some political BS while those people are having their shining moment, what they prepared 4 years for, your ass will be back on a plane so fast to the United States of America, you won't even realize it's happening before you land. It's unacceptable. And I apologize on behalf of her to every single person who has represented the United States of America the right way, and every single person who has traveled abroad, whether it's the Olympics, in the military, for any other sporting event, whatever it's been, and represented this country correctly. Gwen Berry should be ashamed of herself. She wants attention. I feel bad giving it to her, but some things are bigger than this. We went from the Miracle on Ice, where we stared down the Soviet Union, we stared down the big red dog of communism, and we beat them in the greatest hockey game that was ever played, and America was proud to do it, to now we have Gwen Berry behaving like an absolute jackass on the podium, making it all about her, all about herself. It's disgusting. I am disgusted by her actions. As an American citizen, it makes me sick to think that this is what we're sending overseas. And this is the attitude and behavior that's going to be reflected on the United States of America, our current athletes, and everyone who came before them. It has nothing to do with race. If a white athlete went out there and did the exact same thing, I'd say pack your fucking bags, get on the plane, and get the hell out of here. You have no business wearing the red, white, and blue. The moment you leave the borders of this country, we are a united front. And if you can't get that through your head, go home. It's that simple. Speaking of people who have done dumb things, Jalen Rose issued an apology for his comments about Kevin Love being a token on the Olympic basketball team. Okay, did he apologize to Kevin Love? No. What he said, he was apologizing to the game during a bizarre 42-minute long Instagram video where he then doubled down and said he actually doesn't think Kevin Love, still doesn't think Kevin Love deserves to be on the team. Jalen Rose clearly is embracing the attention he's getting from this. He loves it. I think it's complete nonsense. He should be ashamed of himself. I don't think Jalen Rose should be fired. I've said this before. I don't think Jalen Rose should be fired. I don't believe in outrage culture. I don't believe in firing people because they said something stupid like that. I do believe in getting rid of Olympians who can't get their shit together and represent the United States of America, but that's a different subject. I don't think because Jalen Rose voiced his opinion in a way that was not smooth and quite frankly was borderline racist at best, at worst was just flat out racist, should be fired. But he needs to understand, you can't be calling people tokens and boiling down their exact existence to your skin color. If a white person did that about a black athlete, they would be fired. And we can get into a debate about that separately, but Jalen Rose is a smart dude. He knows basketball, right? He knows Kevin Love is a future Hall of Fame player. Why he's reducing him to the fact that he's a quote-unquote, he's tokenism, he's a white token on the Olympic team, makes no sense to me. And then to post a 42-minute long rant about, I'm apologizing to the game, I'm sorry to the game, what are you doing? Just apologize. Say, you know what, I had some time to reflect on it. I could have chosen words that were better. I don't think Kevin Love deserves to be on this team. I could have conveyed that message in a more professional manner. Next time, that's what I'll do. That's all you got to say. That's all Jalen Rose has to say, and this whole thing would disappear. Instead, he's chosen to not do that, and obviously now he's just muddied the waters even more. Makes no sense to me. Topic number three on the idiot train of the day. Scottie Pippen accused Phil Jackson of being a racist during an interview with Dan Patrick because he wasn't allowed to take a final shot in the 94 Olympics against the Knicks. So he did an interview with GQ when he said that the decision to allow Tony Kukoc, who was, I believe, I think he's from Turkey, but he was a young, up-and-coming player on the Bulls, played in the NBA for a long time. The decision to let him take the final shot in the 94 Olympics against the Knicks was a racial move. So Dan Patrick, to his credit, pushed him on this. He said, what do you mean by that? Like, are you realize people are going to think you're calling him racist. And he said, yeah, that's fine with me. I think his exact words were, I don't have a problem with that. And then he doubled down and said that, yeah, he thinks Phil Jackson is racist. This is just another classic example of where we're at in 2021. First off, this happened almost, 30 years ago at this point? So 30 years ago, 27 years ago, he's still holding this grudge against Phil Jackson over a shot that Tony Kukoc was allowed to take? Give me a break. Scottie Pippen, you got 6 rings. I hope you have millions in the bank, although I don't know. You should be beyond this. But number one, a coach drawing up a play for Kukoc does not make him racist whatsoever. And just because someone does something you don't like does not make them racist. Phil Jackson is famous for his ability to get along with just about anyone in a coaching environment. He's coached Kobe Bryant. He's coached Michael Jordan. He's coached a litany of other stars. And yet we're now supposed to believe Scottie Pippen is the only one who ever found him racist. And the reason being, he wasn't allowed to take a shot at the end of the game. Just basketball. Critique his coaching style. Be like, but Phil Jackson being racist is one of the most utterly insane things I've ever heard. The dude is universally loved and, again, is famous for his ability to coach and get along with literally anyone. But yet, Scottie Pippen says he's a racist. Oh, he did something I didn't like. He's a racist. I mean, this is where we're at in America, right? You disagree with someone, you're just a racist. That's how you end arguments now. Oh, you did something I didn't like? You're a racist. We're of two different races? You did something I don't like? You're racist. It's complete nonsense, and it completely ruins any good faith argument or discussion you can have. Phil Jackson is not a racist. And the fact I even have to sit here and say that, the fact those words have to leave my mouth, just tells you all you need to know about where we're at in society. It's really sad because there used to be a time in America where you could disagree with people and you could have fun, engaging debates and conversations. And it wasn't about race. We didn't discuss race. Not everything was boiled down to someone's skin color, which is something they can't even control. So we're supposed to believe Phil Jackson, who helped make Michael Jordan a black man, one of the most successful athletes, if not the most successful athlete the world's ever seen. We're supposed to believe he wasn't racist for that. But Pippen, Jordan's teammate, he was racist for the way he handled him. Give me a break. He's not racist whatsoever. There's no question about it. Pippen should be ashamed of his conduct. Dan Patrick, to his credit, pushed him. And then for Pippen to ask Dan Patrick in that interview if he understood English, how disrespectful can you get? How disrespectful can you get? It's pathetic. It's pathetic. French soccer players were apparently banned from having intimate contact during the Euro 2020 games. Now, I'm gonna admit that I don't fully understand what these soccer tournaments are. I'm not a big soccer guy. But this idea that if you're not intimate, if you don't have sex before games, you're going to somehow play better is the biggest myth in the world, okay? I know a handful of pro athletes. I know a lot of college athletes over the years. No one believes that. Literally no one believes that. There's not a single person on the planet who's ever played at those levels who thinks that if you don't have sex before a game, you're somehow going to perform better. It's not the case. It's not how it works, okay? It's just not the way it works. If anything, if you're loose, limber, ready to go, you will be ready to play better, okay? That's just logic 101. Getting all amped up and not being able to have sex is not going to help you win games. Stop being ridiculous. I laugh out loud. I knew a girl who said that her boyfriend, who was a college football player, wouldn't have sex before games because it somehow helped him focus. No, it doesn't. What reality are you living in? That's complete fiction. I mean, it's literal fiction. There's no pro trainer at the NFL, NBA, NHL, MLB, or college football, college basketball level who would tell you that's true. And I know that because I've asked. They'll tell you that's the biggest myth the world's ever seen. So, a couple of last quick points. Neil deGrasse Tyson doubles down on that aliens wouldn't be interested in humans. I'm getting real sick and tired. I like Neil deGrasse Tyson, but I'm getting real sick and tired of this condescending attitude that those of us interested in the UFO phenomenon, like, we're somehow the weird ones. Like, we're crazy to think that if aliens exist, that they'd be interested in us. As Joe Rogan said, we have the ability to destroy the planet many times over, and we don't do it. We don't do it. So the fact we don't do it in and of itself is interesting. We're constantly in conflict. We have crazy things that go on in this world. Of course aliens would be interested in us. For a guy who claims to be intelligent, and I do believe is really smart, his takes on UFOs are borderline brain dead. Next, Stranger Things. Real quick, season 4 update. One of the cast stars has said she finished filming. That's really good news because now we're at the end of June. At least one major star has finished filming. And that means we're likely on pace for a February-March 2022 release. That's good news. Obviously, we've all been waiting for Stranger Things season 4 to get here. We all want new episodes. Sounds like we're going to get it sooner than later. Star College. Okay, Graham Mertz. First QB, first major college player ever to have a trademark. Okay, this is important for NIL. Name, image, likeness, which means that soon, in July 1st, I believe these rules come into effect, players will be allowed to profit off their name, image, and likeness. You're going to see a whole slew of this. This is here to stay. Mertz is one of the biggest names in all college football. He's getting ready to make some money. I don't really know how he's going to do it. I don't know if it's going to be merchandise, whatever it might be. But he's going to be cranking out content, I guess, money. Get used to this, folks. It's here to stay. It's a good thing. College athletes should have the right to profit. I 100% endorse it, 100% support it. And you're only going to see more of it, so get used to it. So that's the Tuesday episode of the David Hookstead Show. Make sure to check back Wednesday for an all-new one.